In this illustration, we'll discuss about the force on a pendulum bob in vertical circular motion. Here we are given that a simple pendulum of string length L and bob mass M is suspended from a point O, and bob is taken aside so that the string becomes horizontal. And from the position it is released, and we are required to find the force acting on bob when a string makes an angle theta with vertical during its fall. Here in this situation, we can draw the picture. From point O, a pendulum is suspended and the string is taken aside. This length is L and bob mass is M. When it is released, it starts falling in a circular path to reach the bottommost position. And we are required to find the force acting on bob when a string makes an angle theta with the vertical. At this position, we know it is experiencing its weight mg in downward direction and having a speed v. And tension is acting in this direction, and in rotating frame of reference, the outward centrifugal force is mv square by L. At this point P, we can find out the acceleration of bob, and to find the total force, we can use Newton's second law as mass multiplied by its acceleration. So we can write at point P, bob has two acceleration components, which are given as a tangential acceleration, at, which is due to the component of weight acting along tangential direction, which is mg sine theta. And due to mg sine theta, it is accelerating tangentially, so E tangential can be given as only g sine theta as tangential force upon mass. And the normal acceleration would be acting toward the center. And the another component, normal acceleration An, we can write as V square by L, and the speed we can calculate at point P as root 2 GH, because only due to gravity it is accelerating, and the height to which it has fallen H can be written as the string length is L, it is L cos theta. So we can write it root 2 GL cos theta. So V square by L will give us the normal acceleration 2g cos theta. And now we can directly write the total force on bob at point P is, the force can be written as MA total, which is written as root of A tangential square plus A normal square. So we substitute these values, it will be m root of this g sin theta whole square plus 2g cos theta whole square. This is the resulting value. And on simplifying, we are getting it as mg root of 1 plus 3 cos square theta. And that will be the final result of this problem.